Here I've got an Android phone, but if I select the Root Checker app, I can verify that this phone has been rooted. In this video, I'm going to show you how to root an Android phone in preparation for the installation of software such as Kali NetHunter. You need to root your phone if you want to use the full power of Kali NetHunter, for example, to attack Wi-Fi networks. Kali can run on many types of devices. You could run it within a virtual machine. You could dual boot your computer. But in this example, we're going to use a mobile device. We're going to use NetHunter, but there are two versions of NetHunter. We've got NetHunter Pro, which you would use on a PinePhone. I'll demonstrate that in a separate video. In this video, we're going to look at rooting the Android phone in preparation for installing NetHunter. Various phones are supported. So you could use a Nexus phone as an example, a Nokia, various other phones. But the phone that we are using for this demonstration is a OnePlus 7T. So on this device, I'll go to Settings, About Phone. You can see that it's a OnePlus 7T. In this case, we're using Android 11 and this specific build number. Now, in this example, I'm not going to upgrade the phone to a later release of Android. The reason for doing that is I want to get official drivers for the phone. I don't want to install some kind of dodgy software. On the OnePlus website for the OnePlus 7T, the latest software that I can download is 11091 HD65BA. And that's the version of software running on this phone. If I look at system, there is an upgrade to the software. So I could install Oxygen OS 12, but in my tests, that didn't work. So I'm not going to do that. I'm going to stay with this release of Android 11 per this download. Now, you can use the timestamps to jump to a specific part of this video. I want to talk about the reasons that I'm using this phone. I want to talk about Kali NetHunter, the different types of Kali NetHunter that you have. Again, use the timestamps if you're only interested in certain parts of the video. Now, there are different editions of Kali NetHunter. You have a rootless install. Have a look at this video if you want to see how to install Kali NetHunter using a rootless installation. That's the simplest installation of all. There's also NetHunter Lite, which is a full NetHunter package for rooted phones without a custom kernel. And then you have the full NetHunter package with custom kernel for supported devices. To be honest, if you want the power of NetHunter, you need to use a rooted device. As an example, if you want to use Wi-Fi injection, you need a rooted device running NetHunter. If you want to run HID attacks, you need to use NetHunter, not NetHunter Lite or NetHunter Rootless. So again, what I'm going to show you in this video is how to root the device in preparation for the NetHunter installation. I'll do the actual NetHunter installation in a separate video. In this video, I just want to show you how to root this device. OnePlus devices are my recommended device if you want to learn how to root an Android phone. There are instructions out there on how to root other devices. Please let me know in the comments below if there are any other devices that you want me to demonstrate. I will be covering additional devices, but in this example, we're doing a NetHunter installation for the OnePlus 7T version 11. So that's the NetHunter software that I'm going to want to download. But before I even get to that, there are various steps that you need to complete. And to make this easier for you, my team and I have created a PowerPoint presentation. So download the PDF below if you want to have written instructions rather than just follow the video. As always, do not use the information that I'm showing you here for illegal activities. It's only for educational purposes. What you need to do this is a Windows 10 or 11 computer. Now, you can use other operating systems, but because most people use Windows, I'm going to be demonstrating this with a Windows computer. If you want to install Kali NetHunter, you need a virtual machine, as an example, running Kali Linux so that you can compile the Kali NetHunter kernel. Again, I'll show you that in a separate video. You also need a USB-C data cable, and obviously you need a phone. So in this example, the OnePlus 7T. Okay, so as mentioned, we're not going to upgrade the phone to Android 12. We're going to use Android 11. Next step is we need to download the platform tools. So we go to developer, android.com, studio releases, platform tools. And in this example, I'm going to download the SDK platform tools for Windows. You have to agree to the license and make sure that you read that. Agree to the license and then download the platform tools. I'm going to save that to my desktop. And what I'll do is extract that software. So I've now got the software extracted. What we now need to do is unlock the bootloader on the phone. So I'm going to go to settings once again on the phone. I'm going to scroll down to about phone and I'm going to tap the build number 7 times. And what we're told now is we've become a developer. We need developer mode because what we want to do is go to System Settings, Developer Options. And what we want to do is enable OEM unlocking. And we want to enable USB debugging. And you need to accept those two options. So again, we need both OEM unlocking as well as USB debugging enabled. Okay, so the next step is we need to install drivers so that if we brick the phone, we can unbrick it. Some people struggle with this. What you have to do is hold the up and down volume button and power button at the same time. So you might see the volume go up or something else happen, but basically you just need to hold it and the phone will reset and will go into fast boot mode. If you have a problem, make sure up and down volume button held at the same time as the power button. Keep holding it until it goes into fast boot mode. Okay, so back on Windows, we're going to go to Windows Update. We're going to make sure that we check for updates. Go to Advanced Options, Optional Updates, and what you want to see is Google Inc., other hardware, Android bootloader interface. If you don't see that, make sure that you press those three buttons again, volume up and down, power button. Make sure that you see the fast boot mode. Go back into Windows, click check for updates, advanced options, optional updates, and we want to see the software. Okay, so what we need to do is select the Google Inc., other hardware, Android bootloader interface, and click download and install that software. We want that once again in case we brick the phone and we need to unbrick it. Okay, so if I check for updates now, software is up to date. Now, I've had problems if I don't do this, so the next step is to restart Windows. Okay, we need to make sure that the phone is plugged back into the Windows computer. What I'll do is press the power button to start the phone again. Okay, phone has rebooted. I'm going to allow USB debugging. In the platform tools, I'm going to open up a terminal. Alice shows us the software. I'm going to use the command ADB devices to see if devices are attached. You can see this device is attached. You may see that it says services starting and you might have to run this again. You may have to unplug the phone and plug it back in again. You basically need to have a device attached. Okay, we need to boot into EDL mode. So we're going to use the command ADB reboot EDL. Our phone reboots now. So if you don't see that, make sure that the device is attached. Reboot your Windows computer if necessary. Type the right commands to get the phone rebooted. Okay, we're going to run the Windows Update software again. So check for updates, advanced options, optional updates. And what you should see now is that the drivers are displayed. Again, we need this in case we need to unbrick the phone. So I'm going to download and install that. Okay, check for updates. Advanced options, nothing available now because we've installed the right drivers. And again, at this point, you may have to reboot Windows. I've had problems with Windows if I don't reboot it. Okay, so the next thing I need to do is hold the up and down volume and power button at the same time to get it to reboot. We want to boot into fast boot mode. Okay, so there you go. You might just have to hold it. Takes time. Okay, and once that boots, then you press the power button to get it to boot up. Phone is now rebooting. The phone may prompt you to allow USB debugging. So if you've asked that, then make sure that you permit it. Okay, in the platform tools directory, once again, I'm going to open up a terminal. Alice shows us our software. I'm going to use the command ADB devices to see if the device is connected. Okay, I'm going to need to allow USB debugging. You can see that it says device unauthorized because I had to allow USB debugging. Now it's showing as a device because I allowed USB debugging. Okay, now we're going to use ADB reboot bootloader. Phone reboots, as you can see over there. And we should see this on the screen. Make sure that you see something like this, where we see start as an example at the top. And now we can use the command fast boot devices. So you can see the device is shown as fast boot. And then we're going to use fast boot OEM unlock. You should see it says okay, finished in a certain amount of time. And now we're going to use the volume button to move down to unlock the phone. So we're going to unlock the bootloader and then we're going to press the power to reboot the phone. Now, this wipes the phone, may take it a while. Wait until you see a hello message. It's important that you don't set up any face or fingerprint or screen lock once the phone restarts, but you can set up the phone normally with that caveat or caution. Okay, so there you go. The phone has rebooted. Hello is displayed. I can press start to get started, agree to the license agreement. In this case, I'll skip connecting to a mobile network, but what I'll do is connect to a Wi-Fi network. I'm not going to copy apps. Okay, I need to log in with my Google account. Click I agree. Okay, I'm not going to enable all the services. Click accept. Okay, so I'm not going to enable the assistance. So I'm going to do that later. I'll skip Google Play. I'll accept Code Creation Labs. I'll skip a screen lock. Click next. Click next. Click start. Do the home screen thing like normal and press start. Okay, so now I've set up the phone as normal. I didn't set up fingerprint or face ID. I didn't put a pin on the phone. Next thing I need to do is get the model information once again. I'll go to about. Android version is 11. This is the build number. That's really important because I need to download the right version of software. So in this example, this phone is a 1903 phone, HD 1903. That's because it's a European phone. So I'm going to download the software from this link. If you've got a Chinese phone, as an example, you use this link. If you've got an Indian phone, you'll use this link. US Global is this link. And then if it's T-Mobile US, you have to go to the XDA forums because you're going to have to change that phone to a global US phone. So in my example, this is the version of software that I'm running. Phone that I've got is a 7T. So the version that I want for my example is this 11091 HDB65BA. Make sure that you use the right software, that it matches your phone. As mentioned previously, I don't want to upgrade this because this is the only version available. So I'm going to download that software to my computer. Okay, software is downloaded. It's 2.6 gig in size. What I'm going to do is extract the file. And there you go. The file is extracted. Notice we've got a payload.bin file. What I'm actually going to do with this file is copy it to the platform tools folder that we've been using previously. It's easier for me just to put all the files in one place. So the payload.bin file has now been copied to that directory. So next step is to go to GitHub and download the payload dumper tool. So I'm going to click on the link in the PowerPoint slide. I'm going to go to latest and I'm going to download the dumper tool for Windows AMD 64 because that's the operating system that I'm using. And I can't open this, so I'm going to download 7-zip. So download the executable and I'll run that software, install it. So I can right click on that tar.gz file. I'm going to show more options here. 7-zip, extract the files. That is now extracted, but it's a tar file here. So I'm going to have to show more options, 7-zip, extract that file. So now I've got the Go Dumper tool. And what I'm going to do to make it easier is I'm going to copy that file into my platform tools directory. Okay, so ls in my directory. I'm going to use the command payload dumper path to firmware, which I've put in that directory. So it's payload bin. And notice the files are being extracted. The file we actually want is the boot image file. Okay, so under extracted now, there's our boot image. So I'm going to copy that and I'm going to put it in platform tools so that I've got all the files in one directory. You don't have to do it that way. I just prefer having the files in one directory. So back on the phone, go to settings. You're going to go to about phone and then we're going to select software version or build number, depends on your phone. But yeah, I'm going to do build number and I am now a developer. Under system, developer options, I'm going to enable USB debugging. Allow that. So I'll clear the screen here and now I can use ADB push boot image. And make sure that you get the spelling correct. So it's SD card lowercase download with an uppercase D and it's download, not downloads. So we're going to push that software to the phone and you can see that the software has now been pushed. Okay, so on the phone, once again, open up a browser and I'm going to search for Magisk on GitHub. First hit is my GitHub link. So you can see Magisk here. I'm going to scroll down to the latest release, which is 2.5. .2. I'm going to download the first file, which is the APK file. I'm going to click OK to install it. Click Open, Settings, allow that to be installed. Go back, install the software. Press to open it. So Magisk is now installed. I'm going to select Install, select a patch file, go to File Manager, go to Download, select Boot Image, select Let's Go. Software is now being installed. Okay, so that's been completed now, all done. Go back, go to File Manager, say OK, go to Downloads. Make sure that you take a note of the name of the file, because now back on Windows, we're going to pull that file. So in Windows, ADB, pull, SD card, download, Magisk, patched, 25200. And press enter. Okay, so you can see that so many bytes were copied in so many seconds, so that's good. So I'll just do a sanity check here. I'm going to do ls and make sure that Magisk is shown. And you can see here that that file is in my directory on my computer. So I'm going to do ADB reboot bootloader to reboot the phone. As you can see there, the phone is rebooted. Now we're going to do fastboot flash boot Magisk patched file. So that's the file that we copied to our Windows computer previously. And I'm going to press enter. That's been sent to the phone. And you can see that it's now finished. Now we need to make sure that we on start, as we can see there, and then press the power button. Phone will reboot now. Okay, phone is now rooted. I'm going to allow USB debugging. Under my apps, I can see Magisk. So Magisk is installed. So on Magisk once again, as you can see now, Magisk is installed. So in the Play Store, I'm now going to search for root checker to check that the phone is actually rooted. It is rooted at this point, but I'm going to install this app to verify that is the case. So I'm going to open up the software, say agree, and I'm going to verify root. Grant access. And as you can see there, the phone has been rooted. Okay, congratulations. Phone has now been rooted. I'll put a link below to the next video where I'll show you how to install Kali NetHunter on a rooted phone such as this.